I very seldom discuss modern country music on this channel. If you go through my previous videos, you'll see that I mostly talk about the 1980s and 1990s. Modern country is not the focus of this channel. I'm not going to do like a weekly chart run through or commentary videos about any of the current A-listers in Nashville at this moment. It's just not interesting to me at all. But today I will be breaking my silence on the modern 21st century country front, because an issue has propped up within this last week that I would actually say does have some ties to country music history, or one song in particular. Now, if you could not tell by the thumbnail, we will be discussing two songs in today's video, but most of this discussion was spurred by one song in particular. It is a brand new song by Jason Aldean, one of the male singers who has had his reign of terror utterly dominated country music over the past almost 20 years now. I think his debut album came out in 2005. So he has been at the top for almost two decades now. He's had a very impressive run, but like a lot of people who critique Jason Aldean, I don't really think he's a true country artist, not only because I think a lot of his songs aren't very good. When you listen to Jason Aldean's songs, it's big drums, big crunchy distorted guitars. Jason Aldean, in my opinion, is a rock artist. He hits all of the metrics for what constitutes a rock artist, and just because he wears a cowboy hat and sings about country things does not just mean he is a country artist. I consider Jason Aldean to be primarily a rock artist, but that's neither here nor there for the sake of this video, actually. And so right now, Jason Aldean is undoubtedly ramping up for his next album cycle, and a bit over a month ago, he put out a new song called Try That in a Small Town. And it went mostly unnoticed, or I shouldn't say unnoticed, because of course, when Jason Aldean puts out a single, country radio is gonna start playing it like nobody's business till the cows come home. But lyrically and sonically, it is almost identical to every other big Jason Aldean hit of the past decade or so. It is country rock to the max. You have to put in the country there with an asterisk, country rock. Sonically, it is identical to so many other Jason Aldean hits that you probably wouldn't even be able to tell it's a new song if you heard it on the radio for the first time and didn't know the song name. But that all changed late last week when the music video for the song released onto YouTube. And since then, it has been a firestorm of controversy. Critics came out of the woodwork to talk about the song and its lyrics, which decry, the rampant looting and rioting that is going on in big cities across the country, the increases in violent crime, and the video features Jason Aldean and his band playing in front of a southern courthouse. The details as far as which specific courthouse actually are relevant here, but to start off, I'm not going to mention specifics, but he and his band are playing the song in front of a courthouse, and the footage of Jason singing and his band playing are interspersed with, you know, security footage, news footage of, you know, rioting. You can definitely say that the video is making a very hard appeal to right-wing or conservative listeners. And the general theme of the song, along with its title, is down here in the South and in my small town, we don't approve of that sort of rioting, that sort of looting, and hey, try that in a small town and basically see what happens, is the message of the song. You know, F around and find out. Like, that's been a meme for so long now. That's basically the message of the song. Try that in a small town, bring that, you know, criminal behavior to a small town, see what happens. Now, like I said, when this song first dropped, when it was first released, it really went off without a hitch. Like, there were no headlines, at least from what I could tell, about this song whatsoever. I certainly didn't hear anything about it, but then again, I don't pay much attention to modern country music anyway, so it's not like I would have heard it. But this controversy over the past few days has blown up to such a degree that even I am aware of it, and I don't pay any attention to Jason Aldean or what he does. I'm not a fan of his music, but based on what I am seeing music journalists saying, I do feel like I have to chime in my two cents, especially with someone who has a country music history mindset, and also the fact that Country Music Television actually pulled the song and its music video from its rotation. That's a pretty big deal. So Country Music Television, which I was shocked to learn, still plays music videos, so I guess that's pretty cool. It's kind of a throwback. But even Country Music Television has gone to the lengths to censor this video. They are saying, we are not going to play this music video, we are not supporting the message of this video, we're not endorsing it. So Jason Aldean has probably just released the most controversial single of his career right here with Try That in a Small Town. And I just think it's very fascinating because, like I've said now, it's really not that different from any other Jason Aldean song, sonically at least, and even the message of the song is actually not without parallel. It's not some unprecedented take, and yet music journalists and, you know, fans in general, or supposed fans, you know, just people on Twitter, whether they listen to country music or not, are saying that the song specifically endorses lynching. It endorses racist behavior. They believe that the song is like basically saying, hey, Black Lives Matter supporters, we don't tolerate you here. We don't tolerate your ideals. And basically, the tone of the song is actually threatening, like, hey, don't try that around here or you are going to see what happens. Like, we're going to, you know, I don't need to say because I want to get demonetized, but you know what I'm saying? Like, they are saying that the song is a threat. Like, the song is a racist threat that endorses lynching. They specifically say that the song endorses lynching, which it doesn't in its lyrics. It does not specifically mention lynching or the act of lynching, but because of the song's heavily insinuated and implied threats against rioters, looters, petty criminals, in other words, many people are interpreting the song as being racist. Now, here's where one of the details of the music video comes into play, because this song, like I said, was not controversial until the music video was released. And the music video was filmed in front of the Maury County Courthouse. So Maury County Courthouse is in Columbia, Tennessee, which is not very far away from Nashville, the epicenter of mainstream country music. So when you think about it, you think, okay, we want to film this video in front of a historical small town landmark. We'll just go up the road to Columbia and film the music video here. The problem is, there is indeed very real violent history, pretty recent history actually, not super recent, but in the grand scheme of world history, you could say it is actually very recent. It is within the last century, because the lynching, a very high profile lynching of an 18-year-old black man, happened at this courthouse in November of 1927. So what it seems is happening is, folks, critics, whether they listen to country music or not, are looking at this music video and they're saying, okay, the lyrics of the song are saying, hey, we don't tolerate petty criminals and rioters and looters in our small town, this hypothetical small town, right? Don't bring any of that in here. F around and find out. Try that in a small town. And the music video just so happens to be filmed in front of a courthouse in the South, where 95 years ago, a very notable lynching took place. So critics are piecing that together and saying, okay, this song is absolutely racist based on those things. So here's the problem with that. If you want to make the claim that Jason Aldean and the songwriters, because like a lot of mainstream Nashville country acts, Jason Aldean doesn't write or co-write every single one of his songs. So this song did have, I think, 4 co-writers, which is kind of a lot for a song this short, but whatever. But anyway, in order to make the claim that Jason Aldean, his team, the songwriters, and the producers and directors of this music video are all racist, and they intentionally put this song out with racist intent, you have to basically prove that they selected this courthouse specifically as a film location because of the lynching that happened. That would be crazy, and unfortunately, it would be very hard to prove. You would need text conversations, phone calls of Jason Aldean and his team being like, yeah, let's go to that courthouse where that guy was lynched 95 years ago, and we'll film the music video in front of there and really send a message to people. You would basically have to prove that that specific conversation took place in order to say that this song is overtly racist. I agree that the coincidence of them filming in front of a courthouse where a lynching took place almost a century ago, very poorly vetted filming location. Why didn't they just film this on a dirt road somewhere in an actual small town? I don't know. I would have gone with that. You know, anytime you want to film something in front of a historical landmark, especially in today's political climate, you really need to do your research beforehand to avoid situations like this. But to say that this song is specifically racist, this music video was shot, filmed, and put out with racist intent, that is a very tough argument to make, especially because the song is only implied threats. And that's where I'm going to transition into my next point about why I find the outrage about this song to be particularly bizarre and actually a bit misguided almost. I don't know if I should say misguided, but that's kind of how I see the outrage. Perhaps a better term would actually be selective outrage, because think about it. This song, as I've now said like three times, is not sonically different than any other Jason Aldean hit from the past 15 or so years. And even lyrically, like sure, you could argue that he is a bit more specific about what he's railing about. This is definitely one of the more overtly political songs that Jason Aldean has ever put out. But when you boil it down, the song really is no different than any of the other plethora of modern bro country era southern swagger, braggadocious, machismo, testosterone-fueled country songs. Like the whole mindset of, oh, that's how we do it around here. We're from the South. We're small town boys. And don't come from the city and try and start anything with us. That has been the bro country ethos for a decade now. Like, are you new here? Are you getting mad that Jason Aldean is like tough guy posturing about small town southern life? That's been a thing forever now. So saying Jason Aldean is like beyond the pale for saying, oh, don't try that petty crime in a small town. He is very much on brand and on trend for that. Actually a bit out of date considering that the bro country revolution is now firmly in the rearview mirror. So if anything, this song is just kind of out of date, if anything. Although, you know, one could say with the current political climate, it is actually on brand, whatever. The point being, sonically, the song is run of the mill. Lyrically, the song is only slightly more overt than the typical braggadocious Southern values, Southern pride mindset that has been evoked in country music for decades now, but especially since the advent of the bro country era. And when paired with the visuals of the music video, it does take on a much more, I guess you could say, imposing political stance. But even in that respect, it is not unprecedented in country music history, which is what takes us to Mr. Charlie Daniels, the late, great Charlie Daniels, one of the most important musicians in the history of country music, a true icon. And today, we'll be talking about a song, in fact, the title track of his 1989 album, Simple Man. And no, it was not a cover of the Lynyrd Skynyrd classic. Now, if you followed Charlie Daniels, you've been a fan of him for a long time. Songs with politics on his mind are certainly not unfamiliar. He's very patriotic, very pro-America, definitely sort of a conservative populist in many ways. And so to Charlie Daniels fans, or just casual country music fans who are aware of that era of country music and, you know, are familiar with Charlie Daniels, the lyrics of this song will not shock you at all. But what I'm sort of trying to insinuate is that I find this Jason Aldean controversy very funny, because Charlie Daniels did the same thing almost 35 years ago. Well, you know what's wrong with the world today. People done gone, put their Bibles away. They're living by the law of the jungle, not the law of the land. One of the critiques of this new Jason Aldean track is that it glorifies lynching. The song does not make any allusions to lynching. The whole "it glorifies lynching" charge comes from the fact that the song implies vigilante retribution for petty criminals, and the music video just so happens to be filmed at a location where a man was lynched almost 100 years ago. Simple Man, on the other hand, literally talks about lynching, and in fact, the song is basically Charlie Daniels decrying the current state of American culture and fantasizing about what he'd like to do to the rotten apples of society. So now I'm going to read you some lyrical excerpts, and just remember, they're getting mad at Jason Aldean for what he just put out. Compare what Jason Aldean put out to Simple Man by Charlie Daniels. "We tell our kids just say no, and then some panty-waist judge lets a drug dealer go. He slaps him on the wrist and turns him back out on the town. But if I had my way with people selling dope, I'd take a big tall tree and a short piece of rope. I'd hang him up high and let him swing till the sun goes down." This isn't implied lynching, even. This is Charlie Daniels literally saying he would execute drug dealers. Then we go on to the next verse. He says, "As far as I'm concerned, there ain't no excuse for the raping and the killing and the child abuse, but I got a way to put an end to all that fast. You take them rascals out in the swamp, put them on their knees and tie them to a stump, let the rattlers and the bugs and the alligators do the rest." So in this verse, he's talking about basically P-files, don't want to get demonetized, but you know what I'm saying. He's talking about leaving P-files to die in a swamp. You want to talk about glorifying vigilante justice? I got it for you right here. And I'm going to say this right now. This is a much better song. I don't like Jason Aldean, as you can probably already tell. I think the song is no different from the rest of his country rock, you know, copy and paste, you know, mediocre musicianship. This song, in my opinion, is actually very well written. Despite its lyrics, it's actually very catchy. This is just a better song by every single metric. It's actually one of Charlie Daniels' most beloved songs, which is interesting because even back in 1989, this song was controversial. It did hit number 12 on the US Hot Country Singles chart back in 1989. Even back then, music journalists were worried that the song would encourage vigilante violence, and because of that, it was given basically limited play on certain country music radio stations. Programmers were concerned that this song was a little too over the edge, even for Charlie Daniels. So I am, you know, throwing this all together to basically say, I think the Jason Aldean controversy is overblown because we've been here before, quite a number of times as a matter of fact. And, you know, country singers being braggadocious and saying, oh, try that city rioting down here in the South and see what happens. This has been a thing for decades. So are all of these people getting up in arms about this Jason Aldean music video just new? Like, I have to wonder if these people are even country music fans, because if you are a country music fan that is at all seasoned and knowledgeable about country music history, you would know that Jason Aldean is not breaking any new ground or even making that bold of a statement. You think that Jason Aldean is like implying vigilante justice? No, we have Charlie Daniels 35 years ago literally saying what he's going to do to drug dealers. And I think Kyle Koroneos, also known as Trigger on savingcountrymusic.com, a very popular, you know, alternative country music blog, actually makes a good point about this song and how a lot of the criticism of Jason Aldean in light of this song is coming from, you know, misguided music journalists who just a few years ago were saying country musicians need to take more of a stand and be more open about their political beliefs because if they're silent about Donald Trump or blah, 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 they're complicit. You know, the whole silence is violence, silence is being complicit type of attitude that a lot of people on the political left actually have. Because I'm sure just a few years ago, you all remember that mindset when it was prevailing. Like, if you aren't actively speaking out against Donald Trump and what he's doing as president, you might as well be an open Trump supporter. And as Trigger points out, that mindset among music journalists of country musicians need to speak out and we need to bring populism back into country music. And, you know, what about Willie Nelson and Johnny Cash and all these, you know, left-leaning country artists of the past? We need to restore that. There was kind of a push in that for a while, especially with artists like Margot Price and Casey Musgraves, right? Well, as Trigger points out, that's backfired because Jason Aldean previously was not really into being political in his songs and actually said it was kind of a lose-lose situation, but now he finally is being open with his political views, and now people have a problem with it. So it's like, okay, the music press is cool with country artists being open with their political views when it's Kelsey Ballerini bringing out drag queens during her Country Music Television Award show performance, but they don't like country artists expressing their political views when it's Jason Aldean saying, hey, the rioting and looting epidemic in big cities is bad. So this, you know, being outspoken about political beliefs is okay. This isn't. You know, that's kind of what I'm getting here. There's absolutely a double standard because I think it's like the music journals forget that the majority of country music listeners probably still lean conservative, right? Obviously, yes, there are plenty of influential country music musicians historically and even presently who do lean left politically. Some are even outspoken about it, but the majority still of the country music listening public most likely leans conservative on most issues. So if you keep banging down the doors of these country music artists saying, hey, you need to be more open about the state of politics and the state of our culture, well, is it really that surprising when a bunch of guys who grew up in the small town rural South happen to have some views that don't jive with the current liberal left wing? Is it really that shocking to you? Like, are you really, is anyone surprised at all that Jason Aldean thinks this way? That's another thing. It's like, are you gonna get surprised when Ted Nugent writes a song about how much he enjoys hunting. Like, we've been here before. We know what to expect at this point. Why are you acting so shocked that a country music musician who's like in his 40s, in his middle age, happens to have conservative political views? Why are you surprised? Why are you clutching your pearls, pretending like this is some sort of outrage? So I just wanted to come in and, you know, throw in my two cents and especially tie back this current controversy to a previous song that I happen to really enjoy and, you know, to sort of illustrate we've been here before. Simple Man with Charlie Daniels is like the same message, and I think he was much more overt with his messaging. And even back in 1989, that song caught some flack even within the country music industry. So this is not brand new territory. Jason Aldean is not breaking new ground. We have been here, done that, and this whole debate is stupid, but it is going to give the song much more ground and much more attention than it previously would have gotten, that's for sure. I will say there is one thing that made me upset about this song, and it has to do not with Jason Aldean or the songwriters, but with his lead guitarist. Just take a listen to the guitar solo really quick, all right? This first lick of the guitar solo. Do you hear it? I'll play it for you again. Do you still not get it? Okay, I'll play two clips back to back right now. You'll see what I mean. Now that is the biggest atrocity of this song. Let me know what y'all think in the comments section. As I've said now, I think this whole controversy is really overblown, stupid, rehashed even. But hey, Jason Aldean definitely has another big hit on his hands. His hit streak continues, and music journalists just keep taking more L's. See you guys next time.
The tune you're about to do next is kind of controversial. Maybe we shouldn't even talk about it. We should just do it.
Well, yeah, okay. Whatever you think.
But you know what? It's the way a lot of people feel.
Yeah, you know, I got to kind of preface this by saying I'm being a little facetious in the song. I believe in due process of the law, but basically where this about, you know, as far as hanging people, you hear some pretty hard lyrics in this song. But basically, you know, I believe in due process of law, but still in all, what I'm saying is we got a violent crime problem in this country. We really need to do something about it.
Okay, we'll be right back with Charlie Daniels.
You better watch where you go and remember where you've been. That's the way I see it. I'm a simple man.